Policeman?
The policeman brought us both home, John. That's why he was here.
I'm pretty sure he brought something else with him, too. Do you remember what it was?
I don't know. In his other hand?
I bet it was our reward.
No, we were not so lucky. It was a set of lockpicks that we had used to sneak into someone's house. That's why we were arrested.
Did someone come out to investigate all the commotion?
I don't know, adult, male, family member?
It was Mycroft. He smoothed things over and convinced the policeman not to press charges. The officer left and never returned. But we had to endure a serious talk to from my brother.
Ooh. We were scolded.
Mycroft wasn't happy about the fact that we were arrested. Felt like he lectured us for hours.
Did we give him something afterwards, Sherry?
Ice cream?
Oh, yes. Yes, now I remember. It was a letter. That's why we snuck into the house. Mycroft asked us to. He wasn't angry we stole, but that we got caught.
Oh, that's right. It must have been only a couple of months after we moved to Cordona. Ugh, the good old days.
Whoa. How very odd. It appears that memory stood between me and the manor. It's as if my mind palace had seeped into the real world. This deserves further investigation. Perhaps there's more to discover inside.
As long as there is a comfortable place to put my feet up, I'll be happy. Maybe a chaise longue.
Aha. In we go.
Yeah, well, this place is...
Home sweet home, Sherry.
One of the first things I saw when entering this house as a child. It's like deja vu.
We're doing it! Auction notification. We have been instructed that a public auction will take place on the 20th July at Stonewood Manor. Have I been in therapy? Yes, I'm actually still going through therapy. I managed to take it from once a week all the way down to, 1 month. All lots have been selected from the finest pieces of property owned by the Holmes family and have been evaluated by experts. Their authenticity is confirmed.
And I was wondering why it's so empty in here.
There may be a small chance that some of our property could be found among local traders' wares. Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it.
I can feel it coming at the end of night. No, not sex therapy. It's all working down there.
Hey, this is the luggage we brought from London, isn't it? Hey, this is the luggage we brought from London, isn't it?
Oh, the death. Yo, 1869, nice.
Something did happen that day, but no one can tell us the details. How can that be?
Agreed. It's rather suspicious.
Oh, it's also rather dusty in here.
Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it.
Yo, she's doing good. She got back into boxing. So, actually, I don't know how I feel about that. But she did say, like, I'm the only person that can make her feel calm. So, yay.
Mycroft's umbrella.
the only outgoing thing in his wardrobe.
And this weekend?
Another memory incoming, Sherry.
Strange. I struggle to recall anything about the day we moved in. The only detail I'm sure of is that it was raining early that morning. I remember how angry Mycroft was about these marks. He called it a frivolous, childish endeavor.
Yo, it's not if they don't come out. But I think me and her this weekend are gonna go ahead and...
This trip was a challenge for our mother. I tried
to
go
to a place where it's very Christmassy, called Valley View Farms, and see all the decorations for Christmas. And probably gonna make her a very nice dinner after that. So don't tell her, Italian mob, or else. Did I get everything for Christmas? No.
I think our family portrait used to hang here.
In all seriousness, I didn't get her anything. We both agreed that actually what we're gonna do is, because I have a bunch of airfare from Southwest Airlines, is that we're just gonna do one big trip experience, probably in the spring. Probably go to Seattle.
Almost as good as mine. Almost as good as mine.
I heard footsteps upstairs a second ago. Wait, do we have an attic here?
Yeah, precisely. Which means one thing and one thing only.
To be or not to be, that
Viva
is the question. Whether
Vegas,
it is nobler
baby.
In the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune.
And you know, we're gonna have tons and tons and tons of fun. You know what I mean? Yep, tons and tons of fun in Vegas. Now, but in all seriousness, we're thinking about like Seattle or Chicago, but I think if we do Chicago, we should at least do it like in the early summer.
Our mother brought a slew of belongings with her. She refused to leave a single thing in London. Mycroft had to spend the whole day dealing with it. There was always a hat on our stand, but I'm sure it did not belong to Mycroft.
Do you feel it? Is it the air shimmering, or is it my imagination?
Enjoy.
You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate. You're not even trying, Sherry. Concentrate.
Your neighbors will be told that Mrs. Holmes is suffering from tuberculosis.
TB.
It is common to move closer to the sea in such cases.
Thank you, Dr. Richter. No, Sherlock, step away from her. Upstairs, go to your room.
Lean on me, Mother. Take your time.
Actually, I never heard her coughing. I remember now.
Oh, the plot thickens. Oh shoot, Italian mob. You know, less than 2 hours until Halo. We arrived in the early morning of a rainy day. Sherry's mother was weak and unsteady, so he tried to help her. Minecraft was very serious while dealing with luggage. When he saw Sherlock trying to help his mother up, he commanded him to go upstairs to our room. The last person to arrive was the doctor, Otto Richter, who said that the neighbors will believe that Violet has tuberculosis. Sherry just realized that he never heard her coughing.
Oh, I feel dizzy. It's stuffy in here, isn't it?
John, are you all right?
I'll be okay in a minute. How about we find our room in the meantime?
That just happened. Not my room. Ah, here we go. Was the other one.
Look at this. It's like traveling 10 years into the past with a single step. Oddly satisfying.
Cold from Miner's End, sandy dirt from the old city. We scoured the island top to bottom for these soil samples.
Oh, our first chemistry set.
The first chemical laboratory I ever made. I almost miss its elegant simplicity. Look at this, John. Remember how desperately I wanted to learn the violin? I never had a proper opportunity.
Such a shame. I always hated the rule about being silent in this place.
So many pleasant evenings were spent here with the Encyclopedia Americana.
Ooh.
The only fiction book on my table. Still hear my mother reading it to me. Interesting. What's that over there? This doorknob has a cross-shaped end. Too intricate to be merely a handle.
You know what? That definitely looks like a key. Let's poke around and see if we can find any secrets.
A magnificent tool made for a spurious purpose, staring into the sky. I've definitely found a better use for it.
You mean for spying on people? This time I was first to pick beds. This one's mine now.
Hello.
An artifact from Palau carved out of bone and claimed to be 300 years old. My mother proved it was a
fake.
My very favorite plaything. It was the perfect pirate treasure.
Burn.
Cannot believe all my toys still here.
Hey, they were not just yours. They were half mine too.
Oh really? Why don't you pick them up, Sir John? Oh, that's right. You're invisible.
Need to repeat this one day, but with bullets.
Damn.
Sharp and well balanced. It would be a pity to leave such a tool behind. Oh, these must be the notes of my earliest observations. We wanted to locate a particular dog we'd spotted, and we met it, didn't we? I'll never forget how challenging it was to obtain this simple sketch. sharp and well. Need to repeat this one day, but with bullets.
It reminds me of our neighbor. He had the same balloon in his yard, only bigger. Do you remember?
Yes. We visited him several times while living here. The first chemical laboratory I ever made. I almost miss its elegant simplicity.
This time I was first to pick beds. This one's mine now.
No, the box!
The first chemical laboratory I ever made. I almost miss its elegant simplicity.
Minecraft hid the truth about the death of our mother. And lied when he told me she died of tuberculosis. Family friend. While there are no records about my mother's death, we had a family friend on Cordona. He may know something.
Wasn't that neighbor missing a finger?
That does sound vaguely familiar. Wasn't his name, Theodore? Theodore Gildon, perhaps?
It's the perfect time to investigate.
A magnificent tool made for a spurious purpose, staring into the sky. I've definitely found a better use for it.
Yeah, well, thank you, Italian Mob. I appreciate it, man. Feels good. You know? Wait, son of a bee! But...
sharp and well-balanced. It would be a pity to leave such a tool behind.
I think you have to have the right objective for it. Found it.
Perfect match. My small archive of crime clippings. Maybe I should pick up this habit again.
Yes, a wooden pipe.
Made of cherry wood. Father's favorite. Still has a faint odor of tobacco, one of the few things on this island that smelt like home.
The pipe of Seeger Holmes. A small, straight smoking pipe made of cherry wood that belonged to Sherry's late father, Seeger Holmes. We had to hide it from Violet, as she didn't know we stole it from his cabinet in London. The wood is old. Its surface worn from frequent use, but it has been well maintained. A faint scent of tobacco lingers. Holmes has taken his father's pipe with him. I sense it carries considerable sentimental value.
I knew you'd find it in no time.
Suck it, John.
Another one. There must be something important behind it. I can feel it.
Dude, every single time he says I can feel it. I just want to play that one song by Phil Collins where it goes like, but-up, do-do-up, do-do-up. I can feel it coming at the end of night. Hold on. Thanks. You know what? I have you guys to really think, kind of going through the hard times with me for like 2 years ago when kind of like everything was really falling apart and you guys stuck with me through it all. Like, I'm really happy about that. And now we're kind of, as a community, we stuck through it together. And you know what, Italian mom, you have a beautiful baby. Techno, you're one of the most dedicated people, dude, ever. Let's see. Messi is still a butt of a joke, no matter what. I know, I just had to throw that in there because humor is always going to be, for me, one of those defense mechanisms. And it just feels nice, like, there was a lot of people who just lurk and were just here for a chill time. And you know, and I'm happy that at the end of the day, maybe I can give you guys a few laughs and we can all just relax. And you know what? If we manage just to say, even at 7, 16, 5, whatever, you know, I think I'll be happy for that. As long as I have you guys to kind of be there with all the way. But I gotta get to bed. Gotta teach tomorrow. It's midday. Unfortunately, any semblance of snow has vanished. So, looks like a full day for me. I was hoping for at least a delay. Either way, rest easy. Stay cheesy, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. 7:30 EST.